Trucking Adventures number 61, and in today's episode we're going to be going round in Madrid. So we're going to be doing two deliveries in this episode because they are going to be very short, and it will lead us to the next episode, which will take us on our proper journey, which will get us a lot of money and get us on the way. But before we get into it, make sure you like and subscribe if you're watching on YouTube. If you follow me on Twitch, it's 130 followers affiliate, so do follow me. Please watch me live, that really helps me out. Check out the link in the description below for the playlist. See, please subscribe for the future months, depending when you're watching this. And of course, check out the channel as well, other social media for us. Fast enjoy. Right, so this is what we're going to do today. The first one we're going to do is a freight market. It's an ACC to APP. It's the most expensive one in this area, and it takes us to APP. We're going to take breakfast. I'm going to change that to, I think, a standard with a bogey on the back, because I think it weighs a little bit less, but it carries the same amount of cargo, so it's better for us. Then we're going to go external market, and this is why we're doing this. We're then going to go external market, and we're going to take this. We're then going to take this afterwards of cars from Madrid to Madrid to RT log, because if we just keep refreshing. We're then going to take this after, which is the most expensive load currently within the whole of Madrid, including freight and that there, which will be all the way to Riga. So that will be in the next episode, but the first two obviously be with this one. So let's get underway. Let's do this. Let's take this. Set GPS destination. Yes, continue. We are good. Right. We're currently in this depot. Going to get out of here and go to the other one. We only have 11 minutes, so we don't have a lot of time to actually get there. Let me just turn on the volume so I can actually hear myself. It's been loud. Right, let's go. Straight out again. Round we go. Yeah, we have enough time to make it there, no problem. Oh, they are turning. I thought I saw the indicator going, but I wasn't sure. It wasn't very bright. Now, this depot is glitched. As you can see, there is nothing in front of us. We're just actually going to speed, because we have to go past. This is so stupid. We have to go past, go all the way down here, and turn round. And ta-da! It's suddenly there. I don't know why, what's with this depot, but there you go. No, I've pressed the wrong button. Enter. So if you do have that problem at this, at the Madrid depot, just know that is what has to happen. Right, we're going to change this. Obviously they do the massive tech parts here, maybe that's the problem why. So the oversized cargo. Right, we're going to change this. Yeah, we're going to change it to this one. The reason is I think it weighs a ton less overall. Like the trailers overall weigh a ton less. It's a ton less, but it's the same amount of cargo. Continue. So it's the same amount of cargo. Alright, I'm going to wrestle them. But we weigh one ton less, which is good. Yes, there it is, right. Woo! Obviously, the next delivery we don't have to really worry about. It's over 10 hours before that one disappears, and then we've got a World Truck afterwards. I don't think we'll be more than half an hour on this. Right, that's all loading. It's loaded, off we go. So yes. Holy crap. This weighs a lot. how much does this weigh again? It's 33 tons of cargo. 10 tons in trailer weight, I'd have to say. 9 tons of us here. There's 19 plus 33. So 52. 52 tons we weigh all together. Mental. Yeah, they'll sit there, that's fine. Just gonna take this corner. Yes, we want to be in this lane because we're going round the inside. How long do we have to deliver this? We have an hour 51 to deliver this. It's actually quite tight. Yeah, I don't want to sit behind that. We'll then move over. Yeah, they're turning off. We want to be in this lane anyway. Okay. So, 30 mile, 45 minutes. Plenty of time, plenty of time. Income of £81 has just come in from Vitej. Okay. We need to pay off the loan, obviously, in this episode, hopefully. Hopefully we will be able to pay off the loan. Vitej has leveled up. Obviously we're going to be earning a little bit of money. And hopefully our drivers will bring in enough money as well. I thought we'd be, you know, by episode one a bit further ahead in what we're doing. I thought we'd have Madrid depot actually full out by now. No, it doesn't seem to be the case. Right, we're going up now, and we want to be in this lane? No, we want to turn off the next one, so we're going past this. Although, I mean, it tells me to move over. Yeah. Gentle braking. Up we go. I mean, we weigh 52 tons overall. Pretty heavy. I don't know what the rule is in Spain then. Is it like they just put 8 tons per axle? Like it just doesn't matter, as long as you've got the axles you get the tonnage. So, I mean, we've got 3 on the truck, 3 on the trailer, 2 on the back one. So that's 8. 8 times 8 is 64. So can we weigh up to 64 tons max? We are turning off this one, so we want to be over. Yeah, I don't get it. Gentle braking going downhill. Nothing's coming. But really don't want to stop. Because it takes a long time to go. Anyway, the next load that we're going to take is obviously going to be very, very light. Obviously, we'll see if there is another load to where we want to go, which is RT Log. To see, you know, if there's a more valuable one there. Well, we definitely have one delivery to there. We're using a lot of fuel, obviously, on this as well. Yeah, we're meant to be going 50 km/h. I don't know if I'm gonna get to 50 km/h. Oh, we did. Obviously, we're discovering more of Madrid. I think we should be up to 29% maybe of the map by this point. Nothing's come in. Good, it's a nice wide roundabout. It's what we want. I want to get over in this lane actually. Stop. I've got a few cars going. Go on, go past. There we go. That's AP Pete? What? You're joking, I've got to go down here. There is no way. There is generally no way. Oh, I'm gonna hit that bullard, I think. No, just about avoid it. Wanna stay as close to those bullards as possible. Don't beep me. They're beeping me. But don't beep me. Right, we're round. I want to swing all the way over here. So then we can get into here. Damn, that's annoying. Go. Oh. Here we go. Right, enter. 20 XP. Straight ahead. Oh! Up the ramp! Okay. This is different. Oh. Okay. Don't think I've ever delivered up a ramp ever. Unload. Right. Jump job offers, because we want to get straight out of here. External. Or is it not from this one? No. Yes, it is. Wheels. There we go. I thought we had cars. But we have wheels, so we'll take the wheels. And we go to RT log. Yeah, it was BHV that I was looking at, wasn't it? No, yeah, we're going to take, yeah. Yes, so we're going to take the wheels. And then we're going to go from there. Oh, my trailer behind has just disappeared. It's no longer on the ramp anymore. See, yeah, it's just disappeared. A bit weird. Right. It should be round here. There it is. I should have driven around the other way. Let me go around the back. No, I can't turn around there. Ugh. Hold on. We've just driven around in a complete circle. Right, we can turn around here. Go up. There we go. Got some wheels. Right. This says it's going to take 39 minutes, 24 miles. This is obviously a lot lighter. So, you know, this will be a lot quicker. Yeah, it's a one-way road. So, we're going to go out and down this way. Out through here. I don't know if you can deliver here as well. If that's I don't think it is APP. It's a gate, though. To stop people obviously coming in the wrong way. Right. Kind of go back the way that we did come to here. We just go straight on the roundabout and off. Yeah, straight up to speed. This only weighs 10 tons, so, you know, we're pulling like a third. I think overall we weigh half. Obviously, 6-ton trailer still, 9-ton truck, they're still the same. So I mean we weigh 25 tons overall, so we actually weigh slightly under half. We weighed 52, now we weigh 25. I don't think we're going to be paying off the debt in this episode. We're on 12,000, so it'll be the next episode, number 62, where we pay off the debt and get our first truck, because we're going to get like 171,000, I believe, from that delivery. We might be able to get two trucks. I'm hoping we can get two. I'm hoping we have enough drivers going around where we can get two. Oh my lord, gone. I wanted to be by episode 100, let's go over. I kind of wanted all of like the EU countries to be finished, you know. I think that is possible. Obviously, the more that we buy, the more trucks we have going around, the more that we buy, the more money we're getting quicker, and the more that they level up, the more money they're getting quicker. You know, really helped. Doing these two little deliveries, though, isn't going to get us to the next level. Oh no, that's not. No, here's the turn off. Here we go, yeah. Down here. Okay. Oh, Richard O has just brought in £1,693. Lovely. So it's a 14,000. Straight ahead. And roundabout turn off. I'm just trying to bring a double round here. This is tight. Oh, gate. The gates do delay, obviously, their bits a bit more. The how long it takes to deliver something. Where am I? I think I'll go further down. Yes. And then I see the tanker of what we're gonna take in the next episode. They're gonna follow. Hello, hello. Right. Enter. 40. I don't know whether to just do the delivery in this load as well, because we've done really two quick deliveries. And I don't think that tanker will take us over the 3 hour mark. Right, that is absolutely poor reversing from me. Savageable though. Single. We are not in multiplayer. I don't have enough things to be in multiplayer yet with how people drive and how they crash into you and all the money you lose. Right, only 86 more XP. Right, current job offers. Right, I think I'm gonna continue. I think I'm just gonna take it from here. We're gonna go Riga. I thought I said America then. Right, we're gonna go Riga. Take this chlorine, 179,083 per mile. That will take our total money to over 200,000. Level 62 is a pay to. Yeah, I need. I think from in my thing, probably from episode 100. So I usually do one delivery per episode, but this one we've done two just to get to this place so we can take this. And by that point, I'm hoping to have at least the European countries, the ones in the EU, a depot in each one of their capitals, which should bring in enough money for me to survive everyone crashing into me. But yeah, where is that? America. Anyways, right, we're gonna take this. It's 2,148 miles. It's 49 hours, 39 minutes. We're going to change it though, because I don't want to go through Kaliningrad. I always change it so we go round it, because I hate going through passport controls. So, what we'll do is we'll pick it up, change the route to go to there, and then we'll be on our way. 2 million, but never enough. Oof. I've only got five garages so far, four maxed out. We've just bought the Madrid garage. No drivers in there yet. No trailers. Don't own any trailers yet. I've like crashed into it. So I need to earn a lot of money. This weighs 23 ton. I thought it said 9. Oh, Lord. Okay. I was like, why is it taking so long to pull out? Right, let's just pull over here for now. Stop there. We'll get our thumbnail, of course. Do 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 do. Love it. I'll show you the ropes. I am very experienced on this game. I have been playing it since 2012. But obviously this is all new. Everything like that there are some new things. I'm still waiting. I don't think I'd actually do multiplayer either. Until the 1.5 update comes out, but that is very delayed. That is very delayed. Because it was meant to come out by now. Right, let's have a look then. No, Edinburgh. Edinburgh's what I'm looking at. Balance, balance, balance. Long distance. I think these are also long distance. We're not really worried about anything yet. Yeah, okay. We're on 15,000. Right. We need to change our route up here because I'm not going through Killian Grant. I mean, look, you go through here, you go through two borders, which just take forever. It's just easier going through this way. It's just so much easier. We actually haven't delivered into Riga before. I don't think we've delivered into... this is Latvia. No, this is Lithuania? Yeah. Latvia, Lithuania, Estate. No. It's in alphabetical order. But I've forgotten now which way round it is. If it's E, if it's... No, but it should be the middle one anyway. So Latvia, this should be Lithuania. So we haven't delivered into here before. So this will be new discovery. What have we got round here? Oh, we're going into NSC Chemical, so that means we're going to get should get some really good value cargoes coming out from here. Right. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N. No, it should be Latvia. Yeah, Latvia's the middle one. I can't believe I didn't know my ABCs. Right. 50 hours. 2,200 miles. We should. Our driver should get us enough money to pay off the loan. I'm hoping before we sleep. We've got 8.5 hours till we need to sleep. So I'm hoping our driver's bringing enough money for that. Then hopefully enough money to buy a truck for Madrid, and then our delivery added on will bring in a truck. Considering this is £180,000 we're taking here, each truck plus driver, we need 227. So yeah, let's hopefully get this underway. There's no traffic around here, nothing drives around this part. Still discovering more of Spain. We hopefully then should have discovered 30% of the whole map after delivering this. Obviously, we're going to discover more of Spain. We're going to discover Riga, which we haven't delivered into before. There's NS Oil. Right. Saw a car come in. Oh, they're going to let us go. Very nice of you. Thank you very much. Straight ahead it is then. Oh my lord, we're actually taking forever to accelerate. I thought this was 9 tons. It's 23 tons. It lied to me. No need to rush because we're going to go slow behind this truck. Who I think has come all the way from like the Black Sea. I believe that where that one's come from. That's come a really, really far distance. Right, are they turning straight back off or... Sure, that truck's loving it. They just keep going round in circles. Sure, yeah, just they must be lost. Don't know where they're going. Right. This is a world of trucks delivery, obviously. So it's based on real life time, not game time. We've got 12.5 hours to deliver this in real life time. I mean, if we take more than 3 hours, there's something wrong with us. We are also limited then to 56 or 90 km/h in world of trucks. You cannot exceed that. We are not going through any countries that do exceed that speed limit, so I'm not really bothered. There's only three countries that do have a higher speed limit than 90 km/h, which is the United Kingdom, which isn't the United Kingdom, it's actually Great Britain, because there's no Northern Ireland. Bulgaria and Romania, who can go 100 km/h, but I think it's actually four. I think it is Russia as well, where you can go 100 km/h, which is 62 miles an hour. I'm pretty sure in Russia you can. But we're up to speed, we now just relax. We took out a loan of 48,000, I want to say, in the last episode. So that is the first thing to pay off. Pay off the 48,000. Because then obviously we're not really paying off the interest. So this is now all new road that we will discover. I think we're going to go through the northern border of Spain, France. Which is fine. We haven't had a diversion for a very long time, which makes me feel like we will have a diversion. Oh, flipping out. We will have a diversion on this route. Right. Turning off then. Straight off. Onto the 1A. Why are you braking for? Ah, that's why. Oi, don't brake check me. Behind the Vauxhall. Astra or Opel Astra, depending where you're from. Right, these guys are going so slow. We can pull out. And oh, now we're going slow. Yeah. Now they are going slow. Right, go. Holy crap, that scared the crap out of me. That car came out from nowhere. I swear it pulled out from behind me. I hate this. I actually hate the AI cars, right? How they, look, they do this. Look, they speed up, brake, speed up, brake, speed up, brake. I hate them. Passion. That's what caused that situation. And thinking overall, if we've got 23 tons, I'm thinking overall we'd probably weigh about 39 tons. Obviously we are going through Germany, so we can't weigh more than 40 tons overall. What's our fuel saying? 250 miles. We still have 7 hours of driving. But we only have like 5 hours worth of fuel. To be fair, that is because we just did two deliveries driving around. And one of them was very, 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 very heavy. So it used up a lot of fuel. If this was the 9-ton weight that I thought it was, we'd obviously be using a lot less fuel. So I wouldn't really need to worry. But yeah, we got £15,000 in the bank. Like, why are you braking? It's thin air in front of you. Stop. Ah, that's why. Oh my lord. Go, 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 go. Speaking of earlier, of the 1.5 update, it is delayed. It is delayed. The beta hasn't even come out. I think they said the reason it's delayed is because of the Switzerland rework. Oh, for flip's sake, I just got a minus. Driver Andre G couldn't find a job. What's he cost me? 1,300 he's cost me. Great. What's going on? Why have we got to go so slowly? Yeah, but I want to go 80 km/h, but this car in front's not letting me. And so the Switzerland rework is causing 1.5 to be delayed. That is a very big bull. Oh, we've just left Madrid. Sorry? We just left Madrid. Holy crap. We've driven like nearly 200 miles. Come on then. Nuts. Right. Not saying. Anyway, Switzerland rework's caught of delaying it. Obviously, in the 1.5 update, I think the Swiss, the whole. Look, there's another ball up there. Ah, that's actually disappointing. I thought it was like a full ball structure. It's not. It's just like a piece of flipping wood on the back of scaffolding. Obviously that's coming out. You're going to have the new trailer updates come out. You're going to have the Scania test center come out in Sweden with 1.5. I mean, if it just keeps getting delayed, right, the new Volvo might come out with it, because they're still working on that. Might as well bring that out with it. What else could they bring out with it that they're working on? I mean, they're still doing a bit of the German rework, I think. They still haven't finished that, so maybe the German rework will also be done with it. So the whole of Germany updated, the whole of Switzerland updated, brand new Volvo truck, Scania test centre come out, and the 1.5 engine. Bring it all out at the same time, might as well. Big, massive update. The biggest update they've ever done. Do you know what? Maybe the Greece DLC will come at the same time with it as well. Use as much of the slip road as possible to gain as much speed. What I'm going to do is, because this is a World of Trucks thing, when I need fuel, I'll sleep at the same time. Because this, we're not basing it on game time. Just so we bring the fuel and the sleep all back into one go. Really need to get to level 36 and unlock all the fuel. If you can hear, and I apologise for this, but I am sort of chewing on a sweet at the moment. It's a lozenge to help my throat. My hay fever is very bad, even during the night when I'm filming this. recording this at 11 p.m. UK time. It's really dried out, and so for me to keep doing this and keep talking, I need it to keep my throat hydrated. I don't think it's picking up on the microphone, and I hope it's really not. But yeah, if you do hear any weird sounds, that's what it is. Right, we can move over. Oh, the low fuel thing's just come on as we're passing a petrol station. How low? Oh, that's not good. That's 2 hours worth of fuel. Oh, I see a petrol station on the map. We're fine. We are fine. Richard's just brought in some money. Did he? Didn't bring in very much. We're still on 13,000. Yeah, we should have enough fuel to make it to the petrol station that is coming up. I need to concentrate more when I'm driving on the roads. It is just after these junctions. Should be okay. I mean, the more we coast, the longer we can drive. No, keep going, don't slow down. They can pull on their cars, they'll accelerate away from us. There you go, there's petrol station sign. I've actually got quite a lot of still fuel. But no, I don't see another one on the map. So we're going to go in here. Because in Spain, they're either really close together or really spread out. And so we don't want to risk anything. $1.41 a litre? That isn't bad, to be fair. £100. Right, so we're not going to pay off that loan until after we've slept. Is there space for me to sleep? Yeah, there's one space. There is a space actually across the road as well. Right, let's sleep. So, we've slept and we're up to £60,000. So, Betsy's just brought in some money. Christine couldn't find a job. It's like, I hate this. I don't know why drivers can't find jobs all the time. 21,000 from Irene. Irene's also leveled up. 21,000 from Marek. Marek's also leveled up. Once this is finished scrolling through, I'll go have a check. So then Lenka also couldn't find a job. That's the last one. Right, so bank. Repay. Yes. 43,000 repaid. So we're down to now 16,000, well, basically 17,000. Driver manager. Yeah, they're all fine. Right. Delivery. They all should. I'm looking at this, maybe not that, but they all, and maybe not Iron J, but they basically, that's a minus Elena. They all should bring me in a delivery. So I should get 19 deliveries minimum. Right, let's get out of here. Which means I should be able to buy, you know, one truck before we deliver this. Considering we are 45 hours away, which means four sleeps. So I'm going to do 10 hours each, averagely. 40 hours of, yeah. That's another four sleeps. Four times eight is 32. So 45 plus 32. The speed limit is 25. I'm going 23. Also, I was following a van. So if I was speeding, that van was speeding, and there was also a car overtaking me. Ridiculous. Bye, policeman. Right. So if I've got 19 deliveries coming in from those guys, like minimum, and we need to get to 200 and say 30,000. We need 215, which is just over 10,000 per person, which is definitely possible, considering we've got drivers that bring in about 30,000 to 35,000 when they do a delivery, and we should get more than that anyway, because we have drivers that can't do more than 6-7 hours without delivering. They're limited on their distance, so, you know, they should bring in even more. Guaranteed though, we probably won't be buying we won't be buying a truck until probably like our last sleep before Riga. Okay, brakes not working that well. As much slip road as possible. Why? Car was in the outside lane and pulled into this lane. Why? Oh, we are flying down here. Yeah, good job I didn't stop in that petrol station, because this was the next one we've come across. That is, yeah, definitely over 100 miles. We're under 2,000 miles away now from our destination. We have got a toll coming up, so we'll just follow these guys.
one of the trucks. Please stay up, please stay up. Yes. Oh crap, something's coming out beside us. I think we're accelerating quicker than these trucks. I don't think so. Nah, we'll stay in this lane. Oh, you got cars pulling out, it's fine. We're not gaining quick enough on these trucks to move out yet. Oh, we are now. Wow. And, yep, car's just going to sit next to us and do nothing. Oh, it's, oh, we are limited to 50 down here. So, another toll's coming up, yeah. Whoa. Wait, we're in France? Oh, we're in France. Looking at that truck over there, that'll probably pull in front of us, yes. No, he stopped! Interesting, I mean, if that was me, I would have gone. But, sure. Right, we're on £18,000. We're now in France. We have 8 hours 45 minutes till we need to sleep. We're gonna go through Belgium, then Germany. I believe. So... I don't know if we're going to make it to Belgium or not. I feel like I want to make it to Belgium before I sleep. Yeah, definitely discovering 30% of the map. Toll coming up. Slowing, 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 slowing. Lift up. Thank you. Okay, I've got a car underneath me. No, they're stopping. Okay, sometimes you have to worry about cars coming out the toll same time as you, because sometimes they just swing into the back of your trailer for no reason. Struggling up this hill. Towards Bordeaux. I'm pretty sure we're going to go round Paris. The southern part of Paris. Keep it full throttle. Behind the Audi, yep. Got a toll coming up. That's fine. it behind them. Once we get into the two lanes, we'll then pull over. One thing about France, actually, and Spain and Portugal is that you go through so many tolls, your fuel consumption is absolutely dreadful because you keep slowing down, accelerating. So much fuel. Why are they braking? £2,000 is just coming from Richard. Very nice. Obviously leveled up. We'll go through massive petrol stations here. Going to Madrid, I think we must have gone through the southern entrance then, because I don't know why we're going a different way. Oh yeah, we went to Luz, didn't it? Yeah, we went to Luz. To Luz on the southern side, yeah. Another. Yeah, so many tolls. 30,000 is just coming from Corey. And I think Corey has leveled up as well. They open, thank you. So it's 50,000 now. Is that truck going to come in? No. Imagine if France passed a bill where you could have double trailers. You could do a double trailer all the way from Lisbon up to Helsinki. Certain cargoes would then become very, very valuable. Obviously, you'd be limited to 40 tons through there, but you have, like, you know, I think computer processors and stuff like that would become so, because you could carry 6 tons, 4 tons in front trailer, 2 tons in the back, 10 tons, and you have, let's say, even 8 ton cab, because, you know, a two axle, that's what most people have. 18 plus 6, you'd have 24 tons overall. You're well under the weight. Be valuable so much. Obviously, you'd have to go a different way than what you'd go normally, which is through France, then Belgium, then Germany. You'd have to go through France into Germany straight away. Oh, we're turning off. I need to get over into this lane here and over again. £6,900 from Marcel. I think Marcel's also leveled up. Yes, Marcel has leveled up. But there we go, we're getting the money in now. So up to 56,000 already. We still have over 6.5 hours till we need to sleep. So we possibly could get to 100,000 in the bank before we sleep. One thing that I have done, actually, which we might see on this route, is if we come across a train line, I don't think we're going to come across any train lines until possibly we reach past, well, maybe Poland. I think we would go across one in Poland. Yeah, there has been something in the workshop, realistic train lengths. I finally got it, finally in the game. Not as long as what I thought, though. Trains in Europe seem to don't be as long as the ones they are in the UK. Like, in the UK, you can quite easily have, say, a container, a diesel or whatever, pull it, a freight train pulling containers. They'll have a double container trailer and they'll have like 30, 32 of them on there. It's like, oh, in Europe there's only 10 on the back. It's like, it seems a bit short. We want to stay in this lane as we're turning off. Yeah, we'll stay in this lane. Towards Paris, yes. Toll, that's why. Take that off. It's annoying me. Just stick in this lane. The next toll, sure. Ooh, okay. They're gonna stop or not? Oh, they did stop. I didn't think they were gonna stop. I didn't think they were. I think they were slightly quicker accelerating than us. If they got out from their toll booth maybe a second earlier, they would have been ahead enough to pull in. Right, we're under the 40-hour mark now to our destination. 1,700 miles to go. £56,000 in the bank. Oh, it just keeps breaking us. Oh, we are gaining. Pull out. We've got another junction up ahead. I don't know if we're gonna, what lane we're gonna be in. We'll pull into this one. Straight ahead through here. Right, how long until we need to sleep? 5 hours. So, still loads of time to go. Fuel wise, 450 miles worth of fuel to go. So, don't need to worry about that. I mean, at this speed, average, say 50 mile an hour, we're only going to do about another 250 miles maximum. So, no need to worry. even more road being discovered. We're discovering so much road, actually, in France. Incredible. Paris will be the next place that we do buy a depot. With the same current trucks that we own. I'm just going to pull here, because to let them on. They're all pulling on. Yeah, we can move back over. I don't need to worry about going to Paris anytime soon. I think I can do this delivery plus another two deliveries. Well, to be fair, it just depends, obviously, when we get to Riga. There might be one to Paris that might be, you know, over £100,000 load. I'll take it to Paris. Because, I mean, the journey of there to Paris should, with all our drivers, should get us another truck anyway, plus the upgrade of the garage. Obviously, if we get one truck in Madrid, it means there's another truck earning us money. So money's coming in even quicker. These are some weird petrol stations we're going to pass. I've got, like, a truck sitting in the outside lane who hasn't gained on me whatsoever and is just still sitting there. I think they did the same as me, where they pulled out on that exit slip road just to let vehicles obviously come onto the motorway, and now they're just sitting there and they can't get back over. Maybe possibly going like 1 mile an hour faster than us, they're like ever so slightly. See it sitting there. I don't know if you can see it in the mirror. I mean, I don't think you can. It's going to be so small. But, like, it's just so funny. I was just sitting there for so long. Can't overtake. Can't go past. We haven't gone up any hill yet where we've dropped off from 56 mile an hour, 90 km/h. Although, that truck is getting further and further back away from us. I think, actually, uphill, that's struggling. We only weigh, 39 ton. We've got a tanker with us, so we're really aerodynamic. Because the whole truck basically blocks out the whole tanker. We're following a truck ahead which is carrying cars, so that's a really light load. They ain't gonna struggle up hills either. Three and a half hours till we need to sleep. We're just discovering so much road. Probably over 30% of the map will be discovered by the time we go to sleep. Still no one yet has brought in another bit of money. But just, you know, two deliveries can get us over 100,000. Again, we are going to probably... We're going to spend more on tolls and on fuel, so we're going to minus more into the money. Still going towards Paris. Ah! Right, this is where now it's going to be able to overtake, because a caravan has just come on, and they are limited to 80 km/h. However, the caravan is in the outside lane. So, even if they are gaining on us again, because we're going slightly downhill, they're now going to get stuck behind that caravan. Why it's in the outside lane, no idea. There we go, income of £2,900 from Piot. And I think Piot has leveled up as well. Yes, Piot has leveled up. Why are you sitting in the outside lane? And caravan drivers. Yeah, the truck now is right up behind it. It's stuck now. We're gonna get ahead, and we should have cars that are behind us pull out and overtake. Yes, the first one has pulled out and is now overtaking. There's probably so many cars that I've got to overtake. I think the caravan's moved in behind us, so the truck will then overtake the caravan and then should pull in behind us. Such a long drive, this. Yeah, the electric Renault. I just thought about it. The electric Renault should be another thing that should be added in the 1.5 update. And pull all the way over. Oh, £1,000 has just come in from Richard. £60,000 now. I can't get over, I got a coach. But that car shouldn't affect me. Probably pull into the fast lane before the coach gets there. No, don't be braking. That's a caravan, another one. Yeah, we're nowhere near it yet. We're actually going to be pulling into this petrol station. Yes. So, yeah, I want to stay in this lane. And there's a train going along the top. Pulling into here, because I can't see any other petrol stations on our journey. on the sat nav further ahead, so we've only got an hour and 40 minutes until we need to sleep. So, pull in here, fill up with fuel. Off, sleep. Oh, that's 120,000 now. So Vitesh just come in. Richard as well, £1,000. Vitesh was 500. Income of 32,000 from Monica. And Monica has leveled up. £26,000 from Simone. Simone has also leveled up. So only four drivers delivered. Yeah, it was over £60,000. Just amazing. So hopefully that means after our next sleep. After our next sleep, possibly, yeah. Afford our truck. Yeah, there's not even any tolls we're passing through, so it was a good job I did pull over and sleep and fill up fuel there. Oh, 28,900 from Chris K. Well, basically 30,000, 29,000 there. And Chris K has also leveled up. So now we're up to 150,000. I will check before I go sleep. On the next one, which will probably be in Germany next time we do sleep. I will see if anyone needs to change from long distance to balance. We've got 35 hours, which means it is another 35 minus 10, 25, 15, 5. So another three sleeps. Definitely be affording a truck before we get to there. I mean, if we get three trucks straight away in, it'd be mental. I mean, we've already paid off the debt, so that's one thing off. If I can get two trucks and the debt paid off, that's three things I've done in this episode. And then that means, yeah, a load back to Paris should be able to get me... Well, I don't think it would, no. Get me an upgrade in two trucks. Oh, there's a... Wow, that's a big fire. Holy crap. Why are they still letting vehicles drive past it? Should be closed off. You'd have vehicles on a diversion going the other way. And driving this way, you'd have them only... Well, everyone would only be going through one lane. Freight train. Towards Paris we go. that box van ahead just keeps changing and changing and changing. We're going to go through a toll, though. So, that's why they're all going slower. We're going to slow down as well. £167. Jesus. That is a big, massive price. Right. Towards Paris still. Can't believe we haven't reached Paris yet. Right, so we're on £149,000. We're turning off here. £149,000. Wow, slow. Oh my lord, slow. So say 150 to 230, that's 80, so we still need another 80,000. That's three drivers, basically. If any driver from any driver from like London or Cardiff delivers that, will be good. Three of them. Hill. Turning off again. Control on, yeah. Ooh, that's tighter than I thought. Wow, we're just coming up to Paris now. Wow, it's taking a long way to get here. Right. I mean, we slept before the Spanish-French border. We then slept in France. We should go through the rest of France. And obviously the whole of Belgium. And we should sleep in Germany. And then probably sleep in Poland. We're going to go 70 km/h down here. We're going 50. Oh, Elena couldn't find a job.
No, Elena.
Elena's like minus £3,000. What the hell? Fuel and maintenance costs. I saw that one indicating. I thought we had to move over, but no. Stop braking. We're going to move middle lane, so obviously we can go to the fast one. The end of the next toll. Okay. Is that a train? Oh, it's a train, yeah. Yeah, once we've woken up after our next sleep, we should definitely afford our first truck. Oh, Alex though has just come in with £8,000 and has leveled up. So we're up to 155 now. I do have to check on our drivers to see who needs to change from long distance to balanced. Dream. Yeah, toll coming up. 7 hours until we need to stop again. Lift up then. Oh, my throat. I needed another sweet in to get my throat hydrated. Oh. Right. Turning off at this junction. Oh wow, slow, slow, slow. Okay, yeah, I can understand why it is 50 km/h round here. I feel like that changed up gear a bit too quickly. And yeah, just take it off. It says go through at 30 km/h. I go through at 30 km/h, which is 19 mile an hour, and it just doesn't lift in time still. Come on, you can do it. So we've got over 30 hours to go. 6 hours. Of this remaining. I'm still going around Paris at this point. Considering we've got 6 hours till we need to sleep, I'm hoping we do make it to Belgium. More police going past. Obviously, once we get out from Belgium, it will be obviously be only going then 50 mile an hour the whole way through Germany and the first part of Poland, and then the second part of Poland's very slow, and obviously through I think it's Lithuania at the bottom. That's quite slow. The average speed we do as we continue gets slower and slower, so the mileage is like almost half at the moment, but the time isn't. Pretty sure our next toll is the last toll. Just coming up to it now. Before paid. Yeah, passing through Lille. Looking at the mileage we've actually done on this truck is almost 50,000. By the time we actually change this truck, because I am going to change this truck when we get all the trucks, what I'm going to do is this truck will be given to Christine. Christine's truck will be obviously... I'm going to like have sort of a museum thing, like, you know, every type of truck that we've ever owned. I'm then going to do the challenge of driving each truck brand for 1,000 kilometers, I think it is. So buy one of each of those, do that. Then I'll buy a big, massive Mercedes one, the four axle, which we'll use to do the next sort of challenge of like every heavy cargo, oversized cargo. That's a challenge. There we go. Now into Belgium. Do that and then buy another brand new one of these after. All at the same time, though, while doing that, is buying trailers for all our depots. Right. We have 4.5 hours remaining. We will definitely get through Belgium within that time. Belgium isn't a very big country. Obviously we can still travel at 90 km/h, 56 mile an hour. So we should get into Germany, sleep in Germany, go through the whole of Germany and sleep at the start of Poland, and then our next sleep will probably be at the end of Poland. So 155,000. -200 just come in from Christine. but at least they do delivery, so it counts towards, you know, leveling up. Because I don't think when they drive without a trailer, they get the XP that we get. Oh, don't hit the back of my trailer, don't hit the back of my trailer. It kept breaking as I was pulling out. Timber Turtle. Great name. Better pass this Merc. Yeah, it's behind the cement lorry who's struggling up the hill. We're struggling, but I'm struggling even more. Stop braking. Oh. We actually need to be in this lane, so we'll get over. I hate going through that roadworks. Two car transporters coming up here. If you're gonna pull over, go. Don't just slow down. I'm gonna keep my foot on the floor because, yeah, they're accelerating away. That says fuel tank up. Another Merc. like you got to turn off for Liege, so I'll stay in this lane. I can't go. There's no point trying to get over. Going straight ahead here. Why? No need to brake at all. We still have 3 hours of drive time remaining. Obviously, we're going through Liege now, which is the last bit of Belgium. Right, we will now be heading into Germany. Probably with 2.5 hours remaining, we'll probably have left on our drive time. Luxembourg. No, we're not going towards Luxembourg. Pull over to the Jag. Here we go. Now we come past the Belgian-German border. Germany. We're going to pass this petrol station, or we'll probably stop at the next one. Yes, 2.5 hours remaining. To get back. Ooh, crap. Listen, if you're gonna go past, go past. Ugh. Just sat in that lane the whole time. I hear when that happens, they're flying down the motorway. You put your indicator on because you think, oh, they're gonna go past and you can just pull in behind. And they just slam the brakes on, so then they sit next to you. And it's like, why? Why'd you do this? There he goes. Now they're on the outside lane. Like, do you know what I mean? It's just so annoying. Right, we have 2 hours until we need to sleep. We're going past Cologne at the moment. I don't see any petrol stations on the map, but it will be definitely the next petrol station we will stop at and sleep at. For fuel and sleep. Obviously, we're now going 50 mile an hour, which means our fuel consumption is a lot lower than at 56. One, because obviously we're doing less mileage, six less miles an hour. And also, it's a lot easier for the truck. There's a lot less wind resistance and stuff like that, so it's a lot more fuel efficient. We're a lot lower down in the rev range. You turn... That's a double road down there, right? Oh. Do you turn off to go down? Such a long drive. Still don't see any petrol stations around Cologne. There's a yawn telling us that we are getting tired. See a petrol station. So basically, if we see a rest area, we're gonna have to take it because I don't see nothing on this map at all. An hour and 10 minutes. An hour to go then with that yawn. Everyone's coming into one lane, that's why. Okay, now we're stuck. Holy crap, everyone's slamming the brakes on. Oh, 40 minutes. Flipping, I don't see nothing. We are turning off, but I think it is. Is it two lanes or one lane? That's one lane, okay. Car, we little bit of a bump there. Okay, I see a petrol station now, but it's so far away. Tej has just brought in a bit of money. Before Tej has also leveled up. We've got 13 minutes. Yeah, we're not making it in that time. Oh, I forgot. It's 50. Yeah, we're in Germany. We're in Germany. I need to KOH. It's like, yeah, we're not speeding. We can't speed. No, we're in Germany. Yeah, it's slower speed limits. I want to go off at this one. Yeah, we're 2 minutes until we need to sleep. I can see the petrol station. But it's all so far. They're all so far away from each other. Right, down this one. Ah! There we go. I had my brakes on as much as possible. Couldn't stop. Couldn't do it. Flipping hell. I shouldn't have braked. I should have just gone. I would have been ahead. I heard him. I slammed the brakes on. I don't think I could have braked any better than that. There's a sign for it. We are now over. That four didn't help. £11,000 is just coming from Betts, and Betts should have leveled up as well. Betts is in Lisbon, I think, so, I mean, if they're pulling round double trailers, they are getting a lot of money. See, I don't think, you know, unlike even, I know they're unlocking long distance and everything, but I don't think they earn more money until, like, they can get sort of past Germany rather than going between just Lisbon and the edge of, like, Spain. With double trailers. Anyway, we are on 170,000, so it's not enough to buy us a truck. Before we do sleep, I will be checking. I don't think we've driven through here before. I will be checking who needs upgrading, actually. There we go, right. That driver manager. Edinburgh. So Lenk can change now to balanced. Elena can now change to balanced. Alex can now change to balanced. And then all Lisbon one there. So basically everyone's balanced apart from the Lisbon garage. Christine's obviously, I think Christine is still ahead of Veronica. 12 plus 6, 18. 6, 12, 20. So yeah, Christine's still two levels ahead. But lower rating than these guys. I mean, so, yeah. Lower rating. These guys are higher rating. We're obviously the highest here. We still need two more. But yeah, 169,000. Right. Just drive. Engine off. Sleep. Right, we've got enough money to buy a truck. So, let's just buy it. I'm not going to read through everyone. But yes, truck dealers. Sidays. Buy online. Stock. That one. Left hand. Yeah. That's right hand, yeah. So left hand. Purchase. Madrid. Lovely. And then we need to recruit a driver. That's best so far with two. That's three, but it's got one on the long distance. Oh. I think that two's better. One and one unlocked. Yeah, hire driver. Annetta, welcome.
that was better than that. Oh, there was four for Danny. I didn't see Danny, though. I think Danny's new. Otherwise, I would have taken Danny. But yeah. Right, we're down to... We're down to £6,500. But yeah. Let's drive. Okay. We got brought some money in. So we've got still 24 hours until we make it, which is two sleeps. Which is 60, so 40 hours still. 40 hours before we make it to where we need to be. Yeah, after this truck. Yeah, so 40 hours remaining. With how much we're going to get, which is 180. It's, 20 then, plus 180, 40. So we need another 40,000 from our drivers. And we'll have another truck. We will definitely earn 40,000. But I'm going to say 50,000 from our drivers, because I think we're going to go through tolls, obviously, in Poland, and we can still obviously spend on fuel. So another 10,000 for all of that. Yeah, so 50,000, definitely. That's basically two drivers worth deliveries coming in. Oh, I don't think I set our new driver to unlock long distance. They should do anyway, because I think long distance is the top one. So they haven't got any of that. So when they do deliver, they'll put that on. Wow, there's a lot of traffic down here. Like, a lot of traffic. I mean, we can't even get over because the middle lane's full of traffic. Should I stay here or should I move back in? I think I should stay here. I don't know why they keep... Yeah. I don't know what's wrong with them. Keep slowing down. Is it the caravan? I'm going 53 now and I'm not gaining. Oh, there you go, look, they're braking. Yeah, it's the caravan. They've just pulled out. There's definitely the caravan that's slowing them down. Oh, he's really slowing down. To here. That
truck should move over. That van's going faster than it now. Right. Anyways, we've got 22 hours remaining and 880 miles. So we've done two-thirds of the journey, I think, already. And we've paid off the debts and got one truck in. That truck that's in front just keeps swerving and out. So. We have £5,000 in the bank. We need 220,000 from our drivers to get the next one before we deliver this. Don't think that's going to happen. Yeah, I don't think that will happen. Although, we now have another driver, so we have 20 drivers now working for us, so a bit more money should come in a bit quicker. With the Madrid lot, right? I don't know if I should do this and set them to like unlock all ADRs first, because within Madrid, if you haven't got any levels, I think you just keep delivering with Madrid, 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 Madrid. You know? That might work out better. I'm not sure. So you have constant little bits of money coming in. But they wouldn't level up very quickly. So no, I'll put them all to long distance. Obviously, she should take a long distance first time she levels up. I forgot to put it balanced, yeah, get that. And then hopefully she doesn't finish her next delivery or level up. I think she's probably have to do three deliveries before she levels up anyway. Before I need to sleep. So I can set it to long distance. There's no need to brake. I've got a truck coming past me. This breaks at invisible things sometimes. It is quite annoying. Oh, there we go. Linka just brought in some money. Went out to 8,500. So everyone is now on balanced, apart from, Lisbon and Madrid now. They're on long distance. There's a truck in the outside lane, absolutely flying past everyone. It's the tanker that we overtook. What the hell? There it goes. Gonna surely pull in, try pull in into the middle lane now, right? It's just stuck out there now. On, there's a gap now. It can move. It can get over. There's a gap. They're not going to take it. There you go. It took the gap. And it's going to go again, surely. Fucking front brakes here. I think it did pull in. Right, we're under the 20-hour mark now. 8 hours going, so yeah, we were asleep. Probably with about 13 hours to go, and then sleep again with 3 hours to go. Oh, my rec just came in with £7,500. Lovely. Up to 16,000 now. Been driving for 3 hours, so yeah. Slowly going up. All these speed signs saying 120, so there must be something up ahead. Cruising along. Where are we now? We're going past Madgeburg. Okay. I'm pretty sure we got a third of the way into Germany before we slept. So we should definitely get into Poland. I'm estimating we'll probably be in like maybe the first or second petrol station within Poland, and then we'll probably stop at the second to last petrol station within the top of Poland. Probably the last petrol station in Poland, and then go. Got another truck coming past. They're all going like half a mile an hour faster than me. Obviously, this one ahead is very slowly getting away. This is coming a lot faster past. This Merc. There it goes. I'm carrying Istanbul. One thing that they actually need to do with these trailers, right, is obviously there's only certain companies within certain regions. And it's kind of like you'd never have an Istanbul trailer going this way. Unless they work for the Istanbul company and they're going back to Istanbul. But no, you still wouldn't have them going this way. You just wouldn't have it. I don't know if they can ever work out trailers on certain roads, which should be in certain areas. Like, you've got the base map companies, which are also in going east. They're the same companies. There was no new companies added on for that. You've then obviously got them in the French expansion and the Italia expansion. Oh, and it's just leveled up. I think brought in like, is that our newest driver? I think it's just leveled up. They brought in like £1,000. They're also in the Scandinavian map as well, but there's also loads of new companies that were in the Scandinavian map. We want to get over. Okay, so she's leveled up. She's got the long distance, which means she should drive longer, which means take longer to deliver. I mean, if she's taken like over 5 hours to do one delivery, she's going to take over 5 hours. Well, no, because she's going to go back to Madrid now. Take about the same amount of time, but you need more XP, so shouldn't level up. Stay in this lane. don't think I can ever work out that one. Like, obviously, as a player like myself, like, you're taking one delivery one end to the other, so you know that it is possible to obviously have deliveries go that way. In the UK, it wouldn't really matter because all roads sort of lead outwards or go forwards. So, like, you could have any company delivering sort of two place or whatever, so you don't need to work that out. It's sort of like the edges, yeah. Same with like Spain, Portugal, wouldn't need to work that out either. France, probably. It's like the middle bits, like Germany, Poland, you'd sort of need to work out where these trailers are going. But there's not many companies that need to be worked out. We've got 700 miles to go, 17 and a half hours. We're 2 hours full, 15 almost into this episode. Turning off at this one. Okay, yeah, we're almost in Poland. We're just going round Berlin. So we are going to be in Poland. And we've got... yeah, we're going to have about 5 hours remaining while we're going through Poland. So we actually get quite far in, because... we would get quite far into Poland. We might get all the way down to Warsaw. I'm hoping we get to Warsaw. Just looking at fuel wise, if we do get to Warsaw, I probably don't need to fill up with fuel. I could probably go until the next time we need to sleep, because after then it's all 43 mile an hour maximum through Poland, and even I think it is Lithuania, which is at the bottom, even then it's still really slow. We're not going to go very far. Struggling up this hill. And yes, accelerate. So, this is the last petrol station in Germany. We will then pass the border and then pass a petrol station in Poland, the first one. Yeah, here's the border. I've got a police car next to us. No. That is a Polish police car, I believe. Only thing with Poland is obviously there's no fast tolls, it's all slow pay tolls. Oh, we've got a police car next to us, so we don't want to be speeding. Yeah, we'll go in this one because there's no one here. Watch our speed. Alright, we can accelerate. So, now that we're in Poland, we have 16 hours remaining and 630 miles to go. To 50. Just cruise along. So many tolls are going to come across. We have 4.5 hours till we need to sleep, so I'm pretty sure. I don't know actually. I don't think we will make it to Warsaw. As Poland is, you know, the second biggest country in Europe, it's a lot wider than Germany and France. Yeah, so I don't think we'd actually make it. Right, that truck is speeding. I'm pretty sure it's the police car that's behind it. It is. Here comes the police car. You're not gonna pull that guy over for speeding? No? Fine. Coming up, we're going to go through that, obviously. Not going to stop here. Yeah, 4 hours. Another two tolls coming up that we have to pass through. I'm not sure, actually. Can you sleep at Polish tolls? I don't think you can. I think it is only French tolls that have, like, sleeping areas at them. Pretty sure no other country has them. I know you can't sleep in Spanish or Portuguese. German ones you can't. There's not many German tolls though, to be fair. Italy's ones you can't. Or can you? No, I don't think you can, no. No tolls in the UK, even though when they do a whole UK rework, there probably will be tolls. Like the Dartford Crossing. That's a toll. They might put the M6 toll on, which is the pay for that motorway to go across. I'm pretty sure when the game was developed, the Millennium Bridge, the one that connects Wales to England, I'm pretty sure that had a toll on it, but they didn't put that into the game. Right, we should get ahead of one tanker, but not that one. I'm not paid, right. Oh, we're going to be ahead of the Isuzu as well. So you can sleep at Polish tolls, yes. Ah, what is it? Really slowly accelerating. Boom. Right. Still 3.5 hours of drive time remaining. Slowing down because they're turning off. Oof. Okay. We're still not even 2.5 hours in yet. So we might do this under 3 hours. Got our next toll coming up very soon. This is actually rinsing our... Yeah, it's not helping our fuel economy at all. We still haven't got any money in from anyone yet. We're still only on £17,000. Which is, yeah, not a lot at all. I thought we'd be on maybe 100,000 by the time we went to sleep. We should be over 100,000 when we wake up. With the amount of drivers we have, we should hopefully get a delivery before we sleep. And obviously, deliveries while we sleep. But yeah, at the moment we're definitely going to get another truck for Madrid with how much we should get before we get there plus up what we're delivering. I was kind of hoping for maybe 3, but I'll settle for 2 trucks and paying off the loan. I will settle for that. That is 3 things complete. That is good enough. And then if you do like the next delivery where from here, I don't know, go to Istanbul or whatever, or maybe we go back into like Spain or something, whatever. You know, the only way I'm going to go to Paris straight away is if it's over £100,000 load. Straight from here, straight to Paris. Because obviously we should definitely afford a truck and the garage update on our way to Paris from Riga. Over 100,000 should, with a bit more, should then also give us another truck. We'll still be 1 truck down, you know, money down for a garage. But it depends where you deliver it into Paris. Like, you could deliver the whole opposite side of Paris, and then we've got to take a delivery from there to the proper side, which is more money coming in and a bit more time for our drivers to give a bit more. But yeah, it depends. It depends what we got, actually. I think... From Riga, we won't go to Paris. I think we'll go somewhere, and then Paris. It'll be like 1 delivery, then Paris. We're definitely not going Brussels straight after. That's too close. It's kind of like, yeah, do two deliveries, then to the depot. Two deliveries, then to the depot. After Brussels, we will not be going Amsterdam. That's the next one. And then after Amsterdam, we're Copenhagen. Because then that will be all those, all the type of truck complete. And then it'll be going back to Luxembourg. However, when we get to Copenhagen, Copenhagen to Luxembourg is a bit of a distance, depending how quickly we're earning money. We should obviously be maxed out as well by then, over level 36. So our fuel efficiency should be really, really good. We're going back to there. And obviously the trucks will then become cheaper, as it will become two axle trucks. Possibly might be one delivery after each other then. Not planning that. I'm hoping by episode 100, we have all the three axle mid-lift trucks purchased for all the depots. This is parking. We have 2 hours. I think I'm gonna go past this. Yeah, we have a toll coming up, so, I mean, I can sleep at tolls. Just drive past this. And we'll have a look at the toll to see if we can go further along, if there's any petrol stations or another toll. But we're well into Poland by now. I mean, we're gonna come past Lodz. Ah, yeah, there's two tolls at Lodz, so we'll go past the first toll, definitely. Still, no one's paid in anything yet. The thing is, actually, with our first Madrid driver. If she's done a Madrid to Madrid delivery, does she then go away from Madrid on her next one? Do you know what I mean? If she's unlocked the long distance, now does she go away from Madrid? And then come back. What's with this constant braking? Toll coming up. Just take the cruise control off. So we're going to be behind that brick truck then. Catch up to two trucks actually. £68. And they're moving over two lanes, so obviously they're going a longer distance. We'll catch up. That's a yawn, which means an hour and a half to go, but there is another toll straight after here, so we will go to the next one. Definitely. There is a petrol station straight after that toll as well, so actually we'll go all the way to the petrol station. We're going back past the van. Interesting. That's why we're braking. Yeah, 1 hour and 15 minutes. Okay. Yeah, plenty of time to make it to the petrol station. Plenty of time. Plenty of time. Oh, I got a car that's gonna get right up that van. That van is like not going anywhere. I think our newest driver just did another Madrid to Madrid delivery and brought in basically no money. At the next hole. Go for another one. So like, oh, windmills. I was like, what the hell was that spinning in the corner of my screen? Right. Income, 3,000 from Richard. Let's go. And Richard's also leveled up. The van's now pulled in front of us. Right, petrol station is just up ahead. You can see it on the sat nav now. We just hit the under hour mark, so we need to sleep. So that is perfect. Yeah, we're going to pull in here because obviously we can get fuel as well. There is a toll further ahead. But yeah, 43,000 is just coming from Veronica. Holy crap. And obviously leveled up. Holy crap, that's a big amount. Oh, you're joking. Oh, it's 30 km/h through here. Not 50. That's my bad. Okay, but what's a 60,000? Right, before we sleep, I'm gonna check. Check obviously the drivers to make sure they are correct on if they do long distance or balanced. So hold on, driver manager. Our latest one, yeah. See, like, she got the one long distance, that's fine. So long distance. Everyone in Edinburgh is now balanced. It's these guys that are still long distance. So Marcel and Bet are the first ones. Flipping hell. She's got nothing at the moment. Don't even know where she is. Where's she gone to? She went back to London. Okay. 12 hours, so hold on, 12. So, when I wake up, I'll have a look at who's still got to, you know, who's going to deliver within the time scale. We're up to 63,000, is that it? It actually doesn't tell us how long we've got until we deliver. We only got one delivery during the night. Is that it? Right, hold on. How long until we're meant to deliver there? Okay, so let's say 20 hours then. So anything under 20 hours is definitely going to be delivered. So, that's 1. 2. 3. 4. They come back empty. 5. 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. So definitely 10 deliveries. Definitely 10. I mean, I'm going to have to sleep again because it's 11 hours 40. We've only got 11 hours of drive time, so we'll definitely have to sleep again, probably about an hour or an hour and a half away from our destination. Realistically, I should have just waited till, like, after I slept from that to check on who's going to deliver what. But yeah, definitely 10. We need, not including obviously my delivery, so let's put my one out there, but I mean 60 plus to 1 to 220, say 60 to 230, because we're going to need fuel and toll still, so say 60 to 230. Yeah, 170, no, 165. I'm saying 165, so 165,000 we still need. They're slowing down for the toll. Well, they're not. We've got some pipes on the back as well. So many trucks. There's so many trucks outside. So many trucks. There's just trucks everywhere. That orange one's definitely gone. Oh! What the hell was with that barrier? Right, Warsaw. Side by side. Wait for those cars the other side to go through anyway. This is where the Mercedes dealership is, the big massive one. I'm gonna go before those two. We're gonna get stuck at these lights or? I mean, those three absolutely rocked off. I don't understand how that truck rockets off so quickly. Pretty sure we're gonna go into one lane up here, so might as well stay in this one.
Did we go into one lane?
Well, eventually, but not for like a really long time. So we'll get back over. Yeah, it's not for a really, really long time. We're under the 11-hour mark now. We've got 424 miles to go. It's going to be over 3 hours long, I think, this one. It's just slow speeds, basically. We should get out of Poland, though, before we need to... Well, yeah, we should be within Latvia when we need to sleep next. Obviously, delayed for, you know... Toll and the traffic lights have slowed us down a little bit. Gonna pull in front of me. Do not slow me down. I've only got 10 deliveries before we wake up again. Possibly have an extra one or two deliveries within that time as well. I mean, if I got 10 deliveries coming in and we need 170, that's 17,000 each, but I'm pretty sure we're gonna have about 12 or 13 deliveries, which, you know, brings it down from 17 average each to probably about 14 average each. It's definitely doable by our drivers. I mean, if some of our drivers are bringing in £40,000 deliveries now, it's great. Wow, we are really slowing down. Because cars are pulling into the petrol station. Yes, it was. Car and a truck pulled into the petrol station. They've all turned off. We can go again. Right, they're turning off. Now, what are you slowing down for? Stupid. Accelerate back up again. There we go. Cruising along. Right, we've still got 9 hours of drive time remaining. Still haven't had anybody deliver in yet. I think, though, most of the 10 deliveries will be when we're sleeping. I think most of them were over 10 hours away, between like 10 and 15 hours. So that's all sleeping. don't think we've got any tolls to go through on our journey, so it's just the fuel remaining. Which won't be too much. Parking. Brake, because that vehicle's turning off. Yeah, we're still in the going east section at the moment, still in Poland. Coming up to obviously Bialystok. Construction here. This was all built in 2013. I'm pretty sure they would have finished whatever they were building here by now. Speed camera coming out. That's fine. We're going the speed limit anyway. Right. Pedestrians, they just walk through each other. Okay. That is a lot of traffic. Like, that is... Holy crap, that is a lot of traffic coming that way. A lot of traffic there. A lot of traffic there. And we are following that traffic. That's a lot of traffic that's gone forward. Glad we're right at the front though. Makes a bit of time. Still 8.5 hours to go on the driving. 332 miles. I thought we should be able to go now. Right. Oh, we're gonna catch up to any of those cars. Ah! Oh my god, good job it was a stable thing. My thing just kicked me off. Shouldn't catch up to any of them. I don't know what it kicked me off the game for. Yeah, we shouldn't catch up with any cars that were in that traffic.
Oh, we just got paid in £10,000 by Christine, who I think has just leveled up as well, yes. So Christine's now level 21.
Right, here we go then, into the new part, as that was, I think, the last... No, it's not the new part yet. He's on level 21. Level 21 doesn't affect her at all. She can still carry all the same exact things. Obviously, that means she's still ahead. I think 3 levels now of Veronica. Stays ahead. £74,000 now in the bank. That was below the average of what we wanted, though. We wanted like £14,000 each. She only brought in 10. So we are going to rely on someone to bring in a £30,000 load. Oh! That was a bad move. That was a really bad move. Yep, they've slammed their brakes on. Oh, we have catched up with vehicles in front. Oh. Okay. These are heavy trucks in front of us as well, so they probably are struggling up and down the hills. Maybe the red one in front is. Oh. Oh, they're both turning off. Okay. Turn off then. Flipping hell. We're about to hit the 3 hour mark on this. We've got 7 hours remaining of drive time. 7 hours remaining. Oh. Hold on. We have. Right, hold on. We've got 6 hours 52 before we need to sleep. We've got 7 hours exactly before we make it there. Are we going to make it there before we need to sleep? Somehow we've gained back. I don't know how. I don't think we are. There's definitely some points where we're going to get stopped by like traffic lights or, you know, a bit of traffic. Yeah. Oh, there we go. Mustang going past. Yeah, there's no way we're going to make it there within one go. We're kind of like, we're 5 minutes behind. Look, they've overtaken me, braked and turned off. Great, that's slowed me down a little bit. But yeah, there's no way we're going to make it there. We will probably stop at the petrol station just before. I mean, even if we do make it there within one go, we're gonna have to sleep straight away after we deliver. Oh, going past, okay. Coming to the border now. Good job that van actually did overtake, because I think that truck would have pulled out otherwise. brake from a safe distance. There you go. Now accelerate. At 35 maximum, so it just doesn't, you know, accelerate past that. Here we go then. Yeah. Slovenia it is, because it was the long name. Right, we can go 50 now. Again, that slowed us down very slightly. I'm pretty sure we're going 30 through there instead of 31. Speed camera just passed. So, 6 hours to go as we come into Lithuania. 250 miles to go. So, that's less than 50 mile an hour average. But that average will keep going down and down the closer we get. Oh, we're now perfect. It's 557, 557. So we are gaining a little bit. And then here's the cruise control just like, nah, we're going to slow down. Obviously, you can discover a new city, Riga. Riga or Riga. Oh, there's a car coming, but they're going faster than us. They should pull on. There we go, without affecting us at all. Oh, minus 233 is just coming from Antena, which is our newest driver. So we're on 74,000 now. Yeah, I need 150,000. I'd love to go 50km around here, but we can't. So, yeah. Either, right, when we get to the end of this delivery, we're either going to be, you know, sleeping and then deliver, obviously. Or deliver, then sleep. Now, if we sleep, then deliver, I don't think we're going to have enough to buy a truck once we wake up. Before we deliver this. However, if we deliver, then we need to sleep. We definitely have enough money to buy a truck, then sleep, and then make more money coming in that way. Oh, we can all go to 90km, so let's actually go up to 90km. So, is it actually better for us to deliver then sleep? Because then we have another truck working, bringing us money in while we're sleeping. We're going to be over anyway. At the moment, we're over. We're on 74,000. We're bringing in 180, right? So, we're over. By like 25,000. We're going to have more because we are going to sleep and people will deliver. So maybe if we do deliver this, buy the truck, sleep, and then wake up, maybe then straight after wake up we can buy our next truck straight away. Yeah, that junction is so weird. You have to slow down through it and then speed up again. Oh. Rip it out. What's our timings now? 4:32, 4:25. I don't know. It's going to be so close, I think. Still, yeah, no one else is coming with anything. Oi. Police car there, good job, not speeding. Oh, 31 through here. Again, this car's slowing us down a little bit. I think once we get out of this village, we can go 50, right? 70, okay. We have to slow down for a junction anyway. Should be junction, right? Yeah. Is it? No. So many petrol stations are passing through. 350, 349. Oof. We're a minute over at the moment. Yeah, I think being behind this car though and stuck in this traffic will delay us. Okay, just don't stop in my way. Right, up to 50 mile an hour. Yeah, I'm gonna sleep. Cause we need fuel as well, I believe. 470 on the tank. We've only got 140 to go, so realistically we don't actually need fuel. But if we're gonna sleep, you sleep and fill up at the same time. Right, next junction again. Again, buses. No buses stopping bus stops. I think there is a mod to get buses to stop in bus stops. I'm gonna search it. I'm gonna find it, and I will put it. Which is, yeah. Just make it a bit better, the game a bit better. Also make it, well, might make it a bit longer to do deliveries because obviously a bus is going in and out, causing a bit of traffic and whatnot. Onto the motorway we go. Braked a bit too early, but it's fine. Bus just behind us, I went that way. We haven't crossed the other border yet, have we? I don't think. We're still in Lithuania. Control at 70 km/h. Still, no one has brought in anything yet. I think it is, yeah, everyone was bringing in deliveries between the time we were going to sleep, which was over the 10-hour mark. We're going to slow down, aren't we? Because I think there's, yeah. Yeah, this is a major turn off. We're loads of them turn off. This slows us down a little bit. There we go. 222, 234. Yeah, so we're back behind schedule by about 11 minutes. Sort of crossed into Latvia at this point, I think. Oh, there's a truck coming up. That truck didn't actually slow us down. We've got 85 miles to go, still over 2 hours. So, I mean, our average speed is under 40 miles an hour. Once it gets to the 2 hour mark, I actually check our average speed because it seems like we're going to go really slowly. Still over 2 hours away. Take that off. I believe it's around about here, yes. Right, 2 hours away, 75 miles. Are you following this tanker? No. Okay, £502 in just come by bets. So there's one of our deliveries. Not great though, not great. Right, we have an hour and a half. But yes, there is a petrol station further up ahead, so we will stop at the next petrol station. Thing with here, all petrol stations are really close together. You won't go more than an hour without one. So, the next petrol station will be ours. We are coming up to the border now. I think it is still 70k, make sure who, yeah it is.
Oh, it's Estonia to Lithuania.
Really? No.
Can't be. No, it is Latvia.
That is a Latvian flag. Maybe in the night time, it just you can't really see the colours at night. Obviously, they're all three of them are three stripes across. Completely different colours, though. Right, we've got the petrol station coming up now. We've got another one really close up ahead. Oh, we still got an answer to me. We're going to keep going. Yeah, there's one not far ahead at all. We'll go past this one to the next one. Yeah, it's really close. It's before the dam, actually. I don't know if we can sleep at the dam. I can't remember. Might be a rest area there. There you go, there's a sign for the petrol station to come up. I can't remember if we can or not. I don't think we'll be close enough to the dam from the petrol station to see it. The petrol station's just there. Is there another? Oh, there is another petrol station actually, like on the turn off to Riga. It says we're an hour and 10 minutes away. We've got 58. I'm going to risk it. I'm actually going to go to the petrol station just before our delivery point. We're going to go that far ahead. We can go up to 50 mile an hour along here, so, you know, full speed ahead. Oh no, we can't. What's the point in that? I don't understand that little section of where you can go 50 mile an hour, for what, 80 km, and it's like, nah, 70 km. Don't break for me. I think we've got to slow down through here, right? Yeah. I know we need to rest. No, you can't rest here. Even though it says there's parking there, you can't actually rest here. Through the dam. Right. So, this is now where we go towards Riga, which we haven't been before. So, straight ahead across from here. Up and round. Obviously, you've got the petrol station that's just across there, but there's another petrol station we're going to go past. Yeah, slow down off. Yeah, I know we're tired. Right. Yeah, petrol station should just be up ahead. Oh, we can only go 70 km/h. Oh, we just got some money in from Pior. Right, there you go, you can see on the sat nav now. That is where we are going to rest. As we have no minutes remaining. Oh. It lied to me then. It took longer than I thought. I actually don't know how to get. Yeah. This way to the petrol station. And then this way in, yeah. Yeah, we'll sleep first actually. And then we'll fill up with fuel after. Well, it's 150,000, which is lovely. So much income from everyone, but 150,000 each, that's not going to get us another truck. So, I mean, we've got 150,000 in, plus what we've got going to get from this job is going to get us one truck. Simone's level up again. Yeah, they're all leveling up. Do you know what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to pull over here. You can pull here, right? Yeah. Let's just stop here for a second. Let me just check my drivers. No, they're all still long distance, yes. Right. No. Anyone that says zero or one. 100 hours! Holy crap! 3, 18, oh, they're minus. No, so no one's going to deliver anything. So it is just one truck. It is just one truck. Right, yeah, 12 minutes, 2 miles. Yeah, we're not going to get anything from them, so we're just going to get one truck. But we're going to have quite a lot of money in the bank. We're going to have over 100,000 within the bank. So, you know, it's quite a lot. We'll kind of look at like what deliveries we actually have from here. If there is any two Paris, if there's any over 100,000, I'll be tempted to actually just go straight there. Because the obviously how long it's going to take to get there, we'll definitely get a truck on the way, and upgrade the garage on the way. Telling me to go down this way, and obviously this way we'll discover a recruitment agency, I think. So I might as well do it. There's a question mark. Oh, there's a tram going by.
Also going to go past the depot, which I think Riga is the capital.
Yeah, I can register it. So I believe
we will buy the depot in here one time, one day.
What type of junction is this? Oh, I hit the curb by accident. There's the depot. I don't know why it actually sent me round this way, but yeah, we'll discover the recruitment agency. We need a driver anyway, so maybe discovering that will help us get a better recruitment. It's green, stay green. Yeah, okay, it's worked out for us then. Oh, that gate sticks out a bit more than what I thought. Okay. Uh, 40 XP, please. Yeah, we should definitely level up. Which will give us slightly better fuel.
Lovely.
Hazards off. That on. Trailer off.
Nice. So yes, 2,200. 3 hours, 3 minutes.
Oh. Oh, you're joking. We're less than 100 XP away.
Fine. Right, the thing we need to do now is obviously buy a truck, so truck dealers. We bought one on our way, you know, to there. Purchase this. Bought one after. Lovely. We have 105,000. So, you know, we're going to be quite close. There's four here. That's better than that, because obviously I don't want long distance yet. I want them to get long distance after. Yeah, so we'll get a hire. We'll hire Danny. Danny's got quite a bit of cargo unlocked as well anyway. So there's Danny done. We'll then go driver manager. No, that's garage. Driver manager down to Danny. Danny will then go to long distance. Right, so we're down to 103,000. Okay, so what we'll check now is from here, if there is like a cargo load that is over 100,000, I will be tempted to go to Paris, go straight to there, no matter if it's close to the depot or whatever, just so we're in the area, because then we can do a Paris to Paris delivery, as it's kind of the same size as Madrid, because we'll definitely be buying a truck on our way there and a garage, as we get over 100,000 from our drivers each time. And obviously we're going to get over 100,000 that. So yeah, we'll see. But if not, I might do a delivery maybe down to the West Balkans or whatever, then go across, or we might go past Paris all the way into Iberia and then back across again. So yeah, it's getting to that time of where like you do one long delivery and then another long delivery and you get everything. But yeah, that's it for today's episode, guys. If you have enjoyed though, please like and subscribe, watch YouTube, follow me on Twitch to get to 130 followers and affiliates. If you do follow me, please watch your like, that really helps me out. Check out the link in the description below for the playlist, the previous episodes, all the future ones, depending on when you're watching this. And of course, check out the channels on other social medias, I suppose. Enjoy. As always, thanks for watching. Take care, and bye.